Did you know the Azure Docs are not only open source, but it's currently the fastest growing project on GitHub? Dan is here to show us some cool features, a few tips and tricks, how you can contribute, and maybe a few hidden features today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Dan. He's going to teach us all about Azure Docs. So I'm on the team that contributes to the docs.
Yes.
But a lot of people don't realize that they can also contribute to the docs because they're completely open source, right?
Yeah, that's absolutely right. So if you go to our GitHub repo, Azure Docs, and really all of our docs, including our open source SDKs, are all available for and open for contribution.
Very cool. In fact,
at GitHub Universe, they announced we are the number one growing repo and the number five overall. So there are two from Microsoft, Visual Studio Code and Azure Docs.
That's awesome. So we bookend that, right? Because Visual Studio Code is number one and Azure Docs are number five. That's
amazing. Absolutely.
Cool. And also, not only can you get started here, you mentioned that you can go to the GitHub repo, but you actually don't even have to go to the repo to start helping edit docs, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So we're going to show that.
Perfect.
First, give kind of just a quick tour of all the
awesome
stuff that we have available, including our Azure Architecture Center, guidance, and some of the different features you may not know about, all
Perfect.
The hidden tips and tricks.
Great, let's go.
All right, so first thing we're seeing is docs.microsoft.com Azure. This is kind of our homepage, if you will. You can search by products, SDKs, or architecture, or specific services. If you know what you want to do, hey, I'm trying to deploy a specific architecture, build for a certain app, or certain app models. So what I'm going to do is just show one of our articles, which is blob storage, a common service that allows you to store data. So this gives me the high level overview of how I get started with the service. And you see these quick starts. This is the how do I make you successful in the first 5 minutes. Let's go ahead and just select, and we'll use, why don't we use this one, creating a storage account. And so within here, now we're in an article. And a couple things just to start mentioning here is one of the key things we want to do, make it easy to find other content. So in here, you see this filter by title. And if I just start typing here SEC, I'll see things that are related to security, right? If I start typing Java, what is the Java content that we have in here? So it makes it really easy for you to find. And let's just type something you have no idea. In case we don't find it, you can search all Azure documentation. So in case it's not there.
Interesting.
So a couple other things here. We have our prerequisites and different ways to create the same thing in Azure CLI within articles. And one of the things, especially for those of you who remember MSDN and TechNet, our page is 300 to 700% faster.
Oh, great.
We work great in mobile. So let's actually just change this and you see, ooh.
Nice.
I know, it's so exciting.
I also like the fact that there's actually docs for the portal, PowerShell, and CLI.
Exactly, we don't want, it's what way do you want to learn?
Exactly, that's really cool. And I also like the fact that I can just type docs.com.
Yes,
exactly. A little tip and trick there.
Gets a little easier. So a couple other things. Light and dark theme. So, ooh, I know many of you love your dark theme, and so do we. So
I'm too old for the dark theme.
Oh, yes. And then the last thing is downloading a PDF. So what this does is downloads every documentation page of storage in that TOC. So, you know, you were just talking about using this on a flight.
Absolutely. I boarded a flight, and it was, I think I was coming from somewhere over Europe, and I asked the flight attendant, like, do you have Wi-Fi? She's like, no. I'm like, and I started to panic, and because there was an article I needed to read, and I clicked on that download PDF, and I thought, okay, I'm going to get this one page. It'll get me through the first 5 minutes. Next thing I know, it's the entire document from beginning to end, and I didn't even finish it on the flight, but it was nice not to have to rely on the internet for me to be able to read the docs. I had everything I needed in a PDF, and I was able to be very productive on a flight even when I didn't have internet. So it was interesting because I tweeted that, and people were like, you get the entire thing? I'm like, I got everything, right? I got all the information I needed so I could go and enjoy my flight, which is fantastic.
That's awesome. So just a couple other things. Remember, we have 17 different languages for Azure,
Wow.
So you get that automatically. Another thing that's always been a pain, the PDFs get out of date, Azure's moving so fast, community's contributing. We built the system so an Azure DevOps change from a customer goes into our build and it dynamically regenerates the PDF. So when you download it, you know you're getting the latest and greatest data.
Awesome.
So let's go into this and create a storage account. And one of the things that you'll see here is a couple of commands, and you'll see this green try it button. And what this allows me to do is actually use my Azure subscription directly in the docs.
Very
Very cool. This is going to give me a second to log in, and I'm going to choose which Azure account to do. And this works for both Azure CLI commands and for PowerShell. Awesome. In this case, I'm using Cloud Shell here.
Yeah, CLI.
And I'm going to copy and paste this command. And by the way, this is, you know, a full shell. This isn't like some emulator. If I do kind of echo hello world, I'll see that. Great. So, or echo hello world, and I don't know, let's just pipe it to foo1.txt. Let's try an actual.
Yeah, redirect.
Greater than.
There you go.
And now let's just cat foo1.txt. And we see our value. So look, this is real.
Right.
So, couple things. Everyone loves to copy paste. So let's just do a couple of quick commands here and see if this will work. Okay. So I succeeded. Let's try az group list. And I see my information there. So I'm not going to spend too much time on this. The point is everything's interactive. So rather than you having to download some tool or an SDK, you get this live experience directly in the browser.
Got it.
So a couple other things. Let's exit the focus mode and go back to this tutorial. This allows you to jump between different parts. Feedback. So what happens when you get stuck in the tutorial? We've integrated GitHub issues directly here. So you can actually give feedback directly here. Logging into GitHub, you track your issues. So once that's actually resolved, let's say there's a broken link, you can say, hey, there's a broken link here. It opens an issue against the person, and you'll get notified when that pull request comes back in and actually fix it. So how do we have that continuous virtual cycle of people sending us feedback and us acting on it? And you can even see things like, hey, there's 6 comments from customers asking what the difference between this is, people upvoting, and so on and so forth.
Awesome.
So really deep integration with GitHub. And just the last part, let's say we do find a broken link, we click edit. And so what this is going to do is open up the Microsoft Docs, Azure Docs. I'm going to click edit directly here, which will fork automatically for me.
Okay, so this is interesting. So this is what we were talking about a moment ago. Generally, if I wanted to make a contribution, I'd have to find the repo in GitHub. I'd have to fork it into my account. I would then create a branch. I would then go make the change. I would then commit my changes, and then I would request a pull request. So there's a lot of steps involved. And what you're telling me now is, instead of doing all that, you can find the doc that you're reading. If you need to make a change, you just click on edit, and
right.
The forking, the pull request, all that, and the commit, all that's going to happen automatically for me.
Correct.
Awesome.
Absolutely right.
Awesome.
Yes, it's that easy. And I don't know, let's make a real simple change just so we can preview it here. Let's say we're going to create a free Azure account. And remember, because this is Markdown and we have support for Markdown, we can actually see here, this gives me the yellow highlight and I can see the word there. So before you submit, and I'm not going to actually submit
sure.
this file change because I don't like it, but you see the proposed file change and be able to send, and of course be able to track that. So we have hundreds of customers every month improving our documentation, and that's awesome just in terms of having that great Azure ecosystem.
Yeah, and it's amazing, again, to be able to use the community to help make sure our docs are as good as they can possibly be. Typos can be corrected very simply, broken links can be identified, and I wish all repos were this easy to contribute to, right? Because I'm constantly forking repos, creating branches, setting up the pull request, and we've made it really easy for anyone to go back in and contribute.
Yep, absolutely.
Awesome. Very cool. We're learning all about Azure Docs here on Azure Friday.